I feel like slugging goes through periods where it's super trending and then it falls off. For me though, it's part of my regular skincare routine. And I found it especially useful when I was starting on retinoids, like higher strength ones. It was just an irreplaceable step. I'm not sure that anything else would work better to manage irritation than including slugging. I still use relatively aggressive treatments like tretinoin and lotion P50 from Biologique Recherche. So slugging is just a super easy, quick thing to do to support skin barrier function. And that way I feel like it balances out the aggressive treatments with that additional moisturization. Put simply, slugging is a moisturizing technique. However, most moisturizers tend to be quite humectant rich or emollient rich, like oil rich, whereas slugging probably leans into and embraces more of the occlusive side of a moisturizer. This typically means that slugging involves using an ointment style product that tends to be rich in petrolatum. Petrolatum maximizes occlusion potential in a topical product and therefore limits transepidermal water loss. This should, in effect, make your skin feel really plump and juicy in the morning, and it essentially creates just a protective barrier and also creates a good environment for your skin to be able to heal itself. There is some debate online as to the source of slugging. I think it's mostly agreed upon that the name itself comes from the K-beauty community, but the practice of slugging has been around for decades in various forms. There is also some debate online as to who should actually be slugging, who benefits most from slugging. It does seem to be promoted more as a solution to help dry skin types. I don't agree that it's skin type specific. I think if you're experiencing any signs of dehydration where your skin feels kind of parched, then slugging would be great to explore. It's also not something that you have to commit to every day. It can absolutely be very situational, just like an as you need it sort of thing. The general advice is that acne prone skin should probably proceed with caution with slugging, not because petrolatum itself is a problem, but just because there is a lot more going on with the formation of acne, so it's hard to know what effect you're having when you're applying such an occlusive layer on top of your skin and whether that's exacerbating the situation. I think the truth is everybody's just going to react differently to slugging and applying petrolatum in that type of layer. So there's not like a general rule, unfortunately, that you can say yes for dry, no for oily, yes for acne, no for acne, you know, all that stuff. It is just going to be a little bit of trial and error. A slugging ointment is not really going to be 100% occlusive once applied to the skin. So this is just more of a consideration, just to kind of observe your skin to see how it's reacting. I have acne prone skin and I use tretinoin to manage acne, and slugging has been an awesome add-on to my routine. So I suspect that maybe you might have more problems slugging if the type of acne you have is like super chronic and super, super inflamed. But if we're just talking like more general signs of acne, then I think you'll totally be fine. And the counterpoint to that is that actually a lot of acne treatments can be quite drying on the skin. So slugging could be a good way to balance out the effect of like a benzoyl peroxide cleanser, for example. Again, it's not something that you'd need to do every day. You might just choose to integrate it once or twice a week, just as a bit of a barrier boost. Slugging is a super, super simple process. It's the last step in your evening skincare routine and just involves applying a super thin layer of a petrolatum based ointment. You don't want to feel too greasy, so just a very, very small amount will do. And like with most things in skincare, there really aren't any rules. Sometimes I'll slather on a hugely thick layer. Other times I'm putting on a tiny, tiny dot of it. It's just to see how you go. Although slugging is known more specifically around petrolatum, you could, I guess, technically get away with a similar concept to slugging using maybe like a face oil or some type of skincare balm for probably a similar effect. Petrolatum just became the standard for slugging because it's probably the most occlusive. There is some conflicting discussion out there as to whether slugging might actually make side effects of using something like a retinoid worse, for example. I've seen various perspectives on this from tons of different dermatologists, and sadly, I don't think there's a true consensus. Some doctors believe that you definitely shouldn't be slugging over a retinoid. the theory is that the occlusion might be making the retinoid sort of travel deeper, therefore potentially making side effects worse. While other people and other doctors say slugging is totally fine even over a retinoid, because that's the thing that will actually help manage the dryness and the side effects that might develop. So unfortunately, it's super conflicting advice. I won't really argue or discuss the derm perspective, but just go into my personal experience slugging with TRET. For me, it was a super, super helpful thing to do and absolutely did help manage the side effects from TRET and really just helped with the full retinization process entirely. I did make a little bit of an adjustment when I was first starting on TRET though, and that's that I'd complete my skincare routine through to the retinoid and then I'd kind of stop. So I'd let the TRET, you know, sink in or dry down or whatever for a little while, and then I'd actually do the slugging step just right before bed when I was brushing my teeth. So I don't know if that actually made a difference. That's just how I decided to do it in case slugging straight after would have made things worse. So that was just giving myself a little bit of an insurance policy to try and get the best of both worlds, essentially. I only really did it like that for just the first couple months while I was getting used to TRET. These days, I absolutely slug straight after applying TRET and absolutely no issues arise. A few years ago, there was a rumor that Beyoncé herself uses aquaphor on her skin. So that's actually what led me down this road of slugging, is just hearing about how Beyoncé does it, supposedly. And I think aquaphor is an amazing option, still one of my favorites. You also can't go past Vaseline for anything to do with petrolatum. They're obviously the queen bee in that category. And I think Vaseline is generally considered the preferred option because it's so inert. So if you do have especially sensitive skin or you know that you react to a lot of ingredients, then Vaseline is the no-brainer because it's really just petrolatum. I still love to use aquaphor and Vaseline on my skin. It's just I've probably reduced using these products more to a few times a month just when I really, really want more of an intense moisturization. Ultimately, it just became a texture thing because both Vaseline and aquaphor have a certain texture that feels a little bit superficial and a bit slick on the skin. So it's just not my favorite textural experience. But from effect, they're both really good. So for that textural reason, I personally switched to using b-balm from one of my favorite skincare brands called Build Skincare. And this has been the product that I've predominantly used for slugging for at least the last 2 to 3 years, nearly every night, but definitely on retinoid nights. With b-balm, I'm also able to customize application a little bit more, so it actually mixes well into other moisturizers, but you can also apply it as a separate layer if you prefer. Unlike aquaphor, Vaseline b-balm is actually more of a gelled squalane oil that has a little bit of a petrolatum component to it. So it's still an ointment, but it celebrates squalane more than it does petrolatum. So I would say b-balm is more noticeably semi-occlusive. It doesn't feel quite as like, it doesn't feel quite as much like cling wrap as the others. And because of the included squalane, I feel like it actually nourishes my skin a little bit more overnight. So I feel like it's kind of like feeding my skin while it's creating that semi-occlusive layer. Just the balance Build has nailed it, and I love b-balm so much. I actually call it my skin halo, because once you apply it, it does sit on the surface of the skin, and I kind of say that it like hovers over my skin. It feels quite different to Vaseline because it is more of a gel texture. But I think sometimes when I've spoken about it in the past, people think that it's going to feel like a face oil where it kind of absorbs instantly, but it's not quite like that. B-balm still leaves a layer on the skin. It's just that over time, it's like it slowly absorbs in and you just wake up in the morning with super happy skin. I really love squalane as an ingredient, so this combination just is like chef's kiss. There are other products like this on the market, something like Experiment Buffer Jelly and even Do Skin Barrier Blanket. These two are really nice options as well, especially if you're going for that semi-occlusive feel. They're just a bit more on the oily side, while B-balm kind of maintains this unique gelled squalane texture that's actually quite hard for me to describe. You just have to try it. Another favorite of mine that I have in rotation is the Elizabeth Arden 8-Hour Cream. I basically use this interchangeably with aquaphor and Vaseline, so I just have those three on hand just depending on which texture or scent I prefer on the day. Some people also like using the CeraVe Healing Ointment, and there's also a QV Healing Ointment. These two are a little bit too slick and a bit too oily and kind of greasy feeling for me. So I prefer Vaseline Vaseline or Aquaphor over them, but that's just going to be personal preference. Aquaphor and Vaseline both just feel a little lighter and a little bit less like suffocating. In any case, the results for all of these products should be quite universal across the board. It's mostly about finding a texture that's compatible and that you'll enjoy and want to use, and maybe even an ingredient combination that works well in your skincare routine. I hope I've covered all the key areas related to slugging. Let me know if you have any questions or feedback in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.